thank you right now. I thank you for your people. I thank you for the opportunity, Lord, to worship you. I thank you for the opportunity to be used by you. I thank you, dear God, just for being by my side, dear God. Thank you right now for what you have done already and for what you're getting ready to do, dear God. Because, Lord, we know, Lord, in these times, dear God, you wanna talk to us right now, Father God. So, Lord, have your way. Use this vessel like you want to, dear God. Have your way with me, dear God. I get out your way, dear God, so you can do what you want to do, dear God. Because, Lord, it's all about you and none about us, Father God. We thank you right now. We praise you right now. We love you right now. Have thine own way. Have thine own way. Prepare hearts. Lord, regulate minds. Lord, have thine own way. It's in the mighty name of Jesus, and I do pray. Go on to say some God said amen. Amen. I know I can't hear you, but I know you're talking. Amen. For some reason, I just feel your presence. All right. This blessed morning, we're going to take a look at the book of Acts, chapter number 13. Book of Acts, chapter number 13. And we're going to take a look at verse number 49. And it's my prayer that this word blesses you in an amazing way on this blessed and wonderful morning. Acts chapter 13, verse number 49. Real short passage, but it is so impactful. I just believe in my heart that this is where God wants us all to be as believers. It says in Acts 13, 49, look what it says. It says, and the word of the Lord was published throughout all the region. All right, now, that's the King James Version. Now I'm going to read the New King James Version. It says, and the word of the Lord was being spread throughout all the region. Amen. And that text will go along with what we shared. We are going viral. Amen. I don't know if you got a neighbor next to you, but just tap their shoulder. Amen. Give them the peace sign. I know we got to keep them 6 feet, you know, but I want you to let them know, hey, we going viral. That's the subject on this blessed and wonderful morning. When we take a look at this text, I just want to set it up because I just believe as a man of God, I shouldn't just teach the text and tell you what I want you to hear. I want you to put the text in the context that it's in so that you can understand what God was doing at that moment so that we can apply it to our day-to-day. So let's take a look at it. When it says that the word of the Lord was published or spread throughout all the region, let me tell you what was happening here. See, you had those that were considered Jews and those who were receiving the word from Paul and those who were with Paul. And what ended up happening is that the Jews really had rejected the word or had acted as if the word wasn't for them. But at the same time, you had those who were called Gentiles. And those individuals are those people that are non-Jewish, those that are not connected to being a Jew. And people of God, you better thank God that God extended his love to us who are Gentiles, because you've got to understand, he didn't just say that, you know, he was just going to give it all to the Jews. He said, I'm going to spread my word to everybody that wants to hear it. You better praise God and thank God for that. So what ended up happening, these Gentiles, what ended up happening, they wanted this word that they were preaching. And they asked them to come back the next day and preach, or next week, and preach that sermon again. Preach about Christ. Preach about deliverance. Preach about the coming Messiah. Preach about God's grace. Preach about his mercy. And they wanted that word. And what happened was, after they came back, He was the savior of the world. And the Gentiles wanted to hear that word. And they gave him that word. And see what ended up happening. That word spread. It spread. It spread. And it spread across the region. I want to encourage you all today. See, when you look at that concept of going viral, there's a reason why they say going viral, because we know with this virus, Lord have mercy, that it has spread abroad. Virus spread. So every time somebody say it went viral, we understand that means that guess what? It spread out and it went far beyond where it started. Now I want to share this with you. All over this land, that there's some things that have been spreading. And there's some things that have been spreading. And we can use what's going on right now to understand where God is in the middle of all of this. So you've got to understand that when you look at sickness, sickness has spread all over this land. But you've got to understand this one thing. Don't just look at it in one angle. I'm going to share with you three forms of sickness that has spread over this land. And I believe that God wants us to use that to get back on track. See, there's a physical sickness that is spread across this land. And people of God, I shared with you before that really truthfully, don't you run around and understand and think that really truthfully you can do everything you want to do to protect yourself and this and that and the other. Can I help you? God's will is his will. And I'm going to help you out with that a little bit later. But physical sickness has spread all over this land. But you got to understand this one thing, and we can all agree, there's been a mental sickness that has spread all over this land. And we've got to understand, we're living in a society, in a world where really mentally, we're not stable as we need to be. And all it is the work of the enemy. We've got to understand that it's the work of the enemy. And it has spread abroad. Because let's think about it. Some of the things that are happening now didn't happen as often back in the day, but it's happening so often, it's so common, and now you got to understand that it has spread abroad. And I want to share this with you. The reason why there's been a spread of physical and mental sickness is because worldwide there's a spiritual sickness. Worldwide there is a spiritual sickness that has spread all throughout our nation and all throughout our world. Well, Pastor, what do you mean by a spiritual sickness? Spiritual sickness says that I don't need God. I'm my own man. I'm my own woman. I do what I want to do. I'm a shot caller, baller, do what I want. But can I help you? If you in that category to where you think you don't need the Lord, you are spiritually sick. And there's a spiritual sickness that is spread across the land. You've got to understand, anybody that says they don't need Jesus, they don't need the Lord, are spiritually sick. And they don't understand that they need the Lord. For some reason, the word in the text, it ministered to me. And that word spread. That word spread. See, when you deal with a virus, right, all it needs is a carrier, some contact, and ingestion. That means it gets into the body, right? When you're dealing with a wildfire, I did a study on wildfires. All you need is fuel, air, and a heat source. But I want to encourage you on today, this one thing, that we've got to understand that when these things spread, guess what? They need certain things in order to get from one point to the next. I cannot leave this out. When you deal with gossip, all you need is a lying tongue, and an ear to hear. Amen, if you hear me, right? And it spreads like wildfire. But can I help us on this morning that what God really wants us to understand, that he doesn't want us to be so focused on the physical and on the mental and on all these things that we have in our to go viral over this land, and he's trying to get people's attention to understand that, yes, you've been doing things the way you've been doing it. You thought you was doing it on your own. You was trusting in your money. You was trusting in your success. You was trusting in the things that were close to you. But God said, hold up, wait a minute. Let me put some gospel in it. You need Jesus. And we all need Jesus in our life. Okay, preacher, how in the world can we as believers help the gospel to go viral? I'm so glad you asked me. All we need is seed, soil, and the sun. What? Hold on now, so back up. Help me out with that. All we need is seed, soil, and the sun. Wait a minute, help me out. The seed is the word. The seed is the gospel. The seed is Christ Jesus. The seed is him. The seed is who Christ is. The seed is the word that God has given us to share about him. Well, what's the soil? Well, I'm here to tell you, the mere fact that you're listening to me right now says that our soil and our harvest is plentiful. Well, how so, Pastor? We can connect with people all over the world and share a gospel that really truthfully that people need, but feel as though they don't need. And see, all we need is his word. We need some folk that are ready to receive his word, and we need the sun. Wait a minute, the sun, yeah, not the S-U-N, the S-O-N. Because I'm here to tell you, I couldn't die for you. Your daddy couldn't die for you. My mom couldn't die for you. It took the precious blood of Jesus the Christ to die for you and give his life for you and I. My. I want to share this with somebody on this morning, and I want to share with you really truthfully how God deals with his people. Now, I don't want to leave from here and everybody try to think I'm, you know, trying to be all this, you know, big prophet, prophetic, and all this other stuff. But I read the Bible. Amen. Praise the Lord. And there are ways that God has dealt with his people. Okay, Pastor, help me out. You see, back in the day, if you read the Old Testament and you look at Israel, God's chosen people. See, what ended up happening, God would bless them, and he would deliver them, and he would take care of them. And what would happen was, they'd get kind of, you know, like they were all that, like they brought their own selves up by their own bootstrap, and that they kind of did things, what, on their own, and they come to a point almost to where they didn't even need the Lord, or felt as though they needed the Lord. And what ended up happening, God would allow them to go through some stuff. God would allow them to experience some judgment. Why? Because God was saying this, how in the world would I allow you to treat me the way you treat me? I delivered you from Egypt. I delivered you and gave you the promised land. I gave you all of these things. I provided for you. I protected you. And here now, you're treating me as if you don't even need me. Lord have mercy. See, you just got to sometimes, look back in history to see what God has done prior to. You see, it doesn't take rocket science to understand that. And see, let me tell you what happened during those times. Now, some of you are ready to receive what I'm about to say, and some of you are not, but I just pray to God that he softens your heart to understand what I'm about to tell you. You see, Israel, in those times, there were times they got to the point where they started worshiping idol gods. Gods that were made out of stuff, made out of wood, made out of metal, made out of all kind of crazy stuff, couldn't even talk, and God was the one that was delivering. That was their first mistake. The second mistake is this, is that really and truthfully, they started trusting in all the things that God had blessed them with. So here it is, they're trying to act all crazy, high and mighty with themselves as if they gave themselves the stuff that they actually what? Possessed. Mistreating one another, not loving one another, not taking care of those that were poor, not taking care of those in their midst, not doing the things they were supposed to And God said, hold up, wait a minute. But see, there's one thing, people of God, and I might lose some folk, but guess what? I'm going to preach the truth. See, you got to understand this one thing, is that guess what? When God judged the nations, sexual immorality was on an all-time high. See, you had folk that, guess what, was sleeping in other folk bed. You had men doing the ungodly with other men, and you had women doing the ungodly with other women. And you had a world where they were just doing the unnatural. And God said, hold up, you are not going to blaspheme my name because I set things in order and you're trying to cause what? Disorder. And can I help us on this morning? Anytime we cause disorder and we get outside of God's order and authority, can I help us on this morning? Guess what happened? God will judge us. And see, it is spread all throughout the land. It is spread throughout all the nation. And when God says, okay, since you want to spread it all throughout, guess what? I'm going to show you that I can shut down the government. I'm going to show you that I can shut down that job. I'm going to show you I can keep you in your house even when you want to go somewhere. I'm going to show you that I am in ultimate control. God don't mind doing that to us, people of God. You know why? All he wants us to understand is that we've allowed certain things to spread that God never intended to spread. I want to share this with you, and I pray it blesses you. You see, when the enemy begins a distraction, and that distraction is temptation and sin, the Lord creates an interruption. I'm gonna repeat that. See, when the enemy begins a distraction, that is temptation, getting you off from where God wants you to be, and sin, and then the Lord creates an interruption. Parents, you know where I'm coming from? Yeah. Let's think about it. When you know that child ain't doing right, that they ain't doing what they're supposed to do, you tell them, it's going to stop what? Today, right? And God don't mind interrupting us, wrecking our plans, getting us to pay attention to what he wants us to pay attention to. I want to encourage you right now, and I want to share this with you, and I don't know why the Lord wants me to share this with you, is this, is that if the truth depresses you, then it's time to check your walk with God. See, because God is truth. God is truth. So if the truth depresses you, then it's time to check your walk with God. Hold up, wait a minute. You see, I know many people in the world today, and they have the mentality, don't tell me the truth, just tell me what I want to hear. But how many of you know that it's not what you want to hear that's going to set you free? It's not what you want that's going to set you free. It is the truth that will set you free. And the minute we as a nation, as a world, as the church begin to operate in truth and love the truth and embrace the truth, God's going to continue to cause us to understand that we're not operating in truth. I want to share this with you. Hear me well, and I pray you receive what it is that I'm about to share with you. See, I know we all are experiencing what they call it cabin fever. Cabin fever. Some of y'all know what cabin fever is. You know, where you've been cooped up, amen, for so long. And you're like, oh my goodness, I just can't wait to get up out of here, to get up out of here, to get up out of here. I want to help some of you, right? I want to help some of you. Some of you have to learn to understand that there are times when God wants you to slow down and sit down. There are times when God wants you to take time to chill out and seek his face. See, there are times when God wants you to just slow down, be mindful, and meditate. And what has happened, God has put everything around us on a halt. I want to share this with you. See, you gotta understand this one thing. That guess what? When you look at it, see, God don't mind shutting down. Yeah, the NBA. the NCAA, yeah, all of our high school sports, all of the things that are around us, those stores we like to go in all of the time, he don't mind shutting that down just to get your attention. So you got to understand that, that don't take this as a time to complain. Take this as a time to seek the God of your salvation. Because God been waiting to hear from some of y'all for a very, very, very long time. And I'm here to tell you that you got to understand that God has set us down so that we won't look to Leroy and Jimmy Jane and all these other things and look to this one and look to that one and look to entertainment. No, God said you better look to Jesus, who is your strength. And we've got to understand that and get that in our hearts. See, let's be real. Sometimes we'll try to create environments of laughter, create environments to where we go to different things. And, you know, we'll watch videos all day to try to keep laughing, to keep from crying. Let's be real. You know, we try to laugh, what? To keep from crying. So we seek things that will what? Entertain us. But you see, you gotta understand. I wanna help y'all. See, I don't want you to get to the point to where you start seeking things to just what? Entertain you. I want you to get to the point to where you start seeking God, because those things that's gonna entertain you, they gonna only feed your flesh. But you see, when you seek God, God is gonna feed you. He's gonna feed your spirit. And I want you to understand here that true joy rests in the truth and who God is and what he can do, what he has promised, and that he loves you in spite of you. I want to share this with you on this morning. See, you got to understand that we live in a world where we always look to other things. We look to other people. And we look to what we're used to. We look to what's normal. We look to those things that we can just run to kind of put a band-aid on our problems. But I want to help us here on today that we've got to make sure we seek God. We seek his face. We understand that he is real. And he wants to hear from you. Now, I want to help somebody on this morning that when you look at Jesus and you look at what he has to offer, I'm going to show you two angles to look at. You see, many people don't like talking about it, but remember I shared with you the truth shall set you free. See, when we take a look at what God has to offer through Jesus Christ, his death, his burial, and his resurrection, we've got to understand that there's some blessings he gonna give us on this side. But people of God, whether you know it or not, that guess what? We're just pilgrims passing through. That guess what? They got some stuff waiting up on us on the other side. You see, God may call us home, but you gotta understand, when we say God called us home, we're going to a place that guess what? Your mind can't even wrap around. And see, this is what I want you to understand, that down here, he can bless you. But on the other side, he's going to bless you even more. But I want to share with you what he can help you with, what he can help you with down here. You see, I'm about to share something that many folk deal with, but they don't like to talk a lot about. But I'm going to tell you what Christ can give you. You see, there's some people that I know, they've contemplated suicide. They've contemplated taking their own life. They've contemplated trying to check up on out of here. But can I help you? That is just a temporary, a permanent fix for a temporary problem. And I want you to understand this one thing, that when you have the love of God and you have Jesus in your life and you understand that Jesus loves you, then guess what? That you'll be just like Job. You see, Job had cursed the day that he was born. And he said he was mad that God even allowed him to come out of his mother's womb. But you see, what I just figured out in the text is this, is that just a little talk with Jesus will make it all right. And God, when he speaks to you, he's going to help you deal with a right mind. And he talked to Job, and he just told him these words. He said, where were you? And he was telling him, He is awesome and he is true. I want to share with you on the day that some time in your life where folk will label you as this, as that, or as the other. And people are going to call you this, say you ain't going to never mount to nothing, ain't going to never be nothing, you ain't about nothing, you're going to be just like your daddy, you're going to be just like your mama, you're going to be just like your folk, you're going to be just like the folk you came from. But I want to help you here on today. On this side of heaven, God can help you deal with them labels, because you know what? He'll let you know that guess what? They may call you whatever, but I call you redeemed. I want to bring to your attention that really, truthfully, Jesus was a sinner's best friend. And Jesus got condemned for hanging around with sinners. I want to help somebody on this morning. You might have been labeled. Folk might have condemned you to hell. Folk might have said that you wasn't going to ever be nothing. But I want to help somebody here on the day. Don't you worry about what folk telling you. Don't you worry about the word that folk throw your way. Don't you worry about what people think about you. You got to understand that God loves you when nobody loves you. And you got to understand he'll give you a new name over in glory. See, that's some folk that walk around and say, I'm so all alone. I want to help somebody here on today. Guess what? Jesus can take care of that. Jesus can take care of that loneliness. And you got to understand, Jesus said, I will never leave thee, nor will I forsake thee. So you got to understand this one thing. Even though you may be alone, guess what? We are never at a point to where God is not right there. Right? So you may feel lonely, but you're never alone. And some of you, you've been working, you're tired. Some of you have been working, and you're sick. And some of you have been praying that God move this thing. God, get this thing out of the way. God, I can't deal with this no more. God, I've prayed, and I've prayed, and I've prayed. Lord, move it away from me. Can I help somebody up in here? You might be tired of being sick and tired, but I want to help you on today. Paul prayed for that thorn 3 times, and God didn't move. But he said this, my grace is sufficient for thee. So you got to understand that God's grace will give you what you need. He'll take care of you on this side of heaven. You got to understand, see, God gives us the grace to keep going in life. And when life seems as roughest, it's at your lowest moments where his grace kicks in to let you know that he loves you. And I just want to flip the script on you and let you know that yes, this virus is present. Yes, it is here. Don't you deny it. Don't you say it don't exist. Don't you say that I don't claim it. All that other stuff. No, it's here. But I want to let you know this one thing. I'm going to flip the script. Some of you have read the story about the thief on the cross. And see, the thief on the cross ain't had no time to go get no lesson. He ain't had no time to go get baptized. He ain't have no time, you know, to go ask somebody to pray for him. He told Jesus, he said, Father, he said, I understand who you are, Jesus, and I love you, and I want to be with you. And Jesus told him these words. He said, this day thou will be with me in paradise. I want to share with somebody on this morning that eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, and neither has it entered into the heart of man what God has in store for his people. I'm going to help you, people of God. Your best life is not in the stuff you have. Your best life is in the eternal life that God has provided to you and I. Paul said it best. He says, to live is Christ. As long as Christ got in here, he's going to preach the word. He said, to die is gain. And he said, guess what? If the Lord happened to take me away, guess what? I got a home in glory. And I'm going to be better off than what I was over here. And I want you to encourage somebody on today. Let them know, yeah, I can't judge you. Yeah, but guess what? All of us got to face Jesus. All of us have to face the judge, whether we think so or whether we don't, because the Bible clearly says that every knee shall bow and every tongue will confess. keep you on this side, but I want to let you know, don't you get comfortable down here, that guess what? God got a home and glory waiting on all of us. He just want us to live our lives down here and get ready for where we going. So I want you to go viral with the message of Jesus Christ. Let folk know all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. We all done messed up. We all got issues. We all got stuff that we're dealing with. And guess what we've got to understand is that God will deal with us not based on all the bad stuff we've done as it relates to having eternal life. He gonna deal with us based on whether we accepted Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior or not. So I want you to let you know to share that word and let them know that, yeah, we are all sinners. But guess what? God demonstrated his love, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. And Christ didn't just die, he bled, and he was buried, and he rose again the third day in victory over sin and death. So what I want you to do, saints, I want you to make a valiant effort. Make a valiant effort to go viral with the gospel. I want you to go viral with the fact that people need Jesus. Because all I hear on TV, nobody talking about seek the Lord. Nobody talking about we need Jesus. Nobody talking about that we need the Lord's help. But I'm going to encourage you, saying, in the middle of what we're going through, don't just talk to the folk that you know Jesus. Talk to some folk that you know don't know Jesus. And I want you to let them know that Jesus lives and he wants to live. He wants to live in their heart. I want you to go viral with the word of God. Go viral with the gospel of Jesus Christ. And I want you to make a lifelong commitment to sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ. Sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because you've got to understand that when you look at Jesus and you look at his love and you look at his grace, they've been trying to disprove him for a very long time. But can I help you? He's the only one throughout history. For some reason, they can't get rid of him. You know why? Because he's God. Because we need him. Because he's the Lord. And because he wants us to have a relationship with him.